What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Okay, so today I wanted to talk to you guys about a few things. I want to update you on all of these cars. First of all, I am going to Mustang Week. I am so excited. I bought my tickets last night to fly out there. I will be there Sunday through Friday. So I have my airplane tickets. I have my hotel room. Cannot wait to see you. I know a lot's going on right now and the world's kind of crazy, but I booked my tickets just in case. So if you're going, we'll see you there. Let me know in the comments. Let me show you guys all of my Mustangs one more time. If you're new here, don't forget to like and subscribe. Here is my 2004 Mustang GT. I actually just got this one in my last video, and I totally forgot that I edited out how much I paid for this car. So he had it listed for $6,000. I came in at $4,500. And it was kind of awkward because we negotiated back and forth, but we ended up on $5,100. I think that's a pretty good deal because this is a solid car. So there's not too many things wrong with this car. The major thing I need to do in repairs on this is the throwout bearing. So I'm working with that. I'm talking with the mechanic, and I'm hoping to find someone that will help me learn and show me how to do it so I don't mess anything up, but I still learn in the process. So I plan on getting new wheels and tires and lowering it with suspension. Let's go in the back and I'll show you why I want new wheels and tires. If you see, they poke out a little more than I want. It almost looks like a Mad Max kind of car where it goes off-road and stuff. I like the look of it. Don't love how far they stick out. Before we continue on, can we appreciate this view? It is so cute, they all match. We have the son here, the dad, and the grandpa. On this car also, there's not many repairs I have to do. I have to do the throwout bearing on this one. My plans for this one are wheels, tires, exhaust, and suspension. And this is my 1992 Fox Body Mustang GT as well. This one needs a ton of work and it's a little bit out of my league. I am actually going to work on the Fox Body for the first time. I'm so excited. Okay, I don't know if you guys remember this or not. The guy that I bought this from actually changed the seats out and he bolted the bottom of the seatbelt underneath the seat. Let me show you guys what I'm talking about real quick. And how it's stuck. Oh, here's my tools. Okay, right there is the seatbelt and it's totally underneath. I cannot pull it out. I've tried, but I hear that this one's pretty easy to fix. You guys told me I can unbolt this seat, so I'm hoping that it's okay that I unbolt those two. We'll see how this goes. I think I'm tightening it. Wait. Lefty loosey, righty. Oh, that was right. Holy cow. It was harder than I thought it would be. It's coming. It just takes forever. That's what she said. All right. Oh, I can actually see the road under there. Okay, let's see if this lifts up enough. Oh, dang. I definitely have to undo this one too. Holy. Oh! Holy cow. Okay. Oh. Almost there. Oh, holy cow. Okay. I did it. First repair on the Fox Body. It is so hot out here right now. Hopefully you can't tell I'm sweating. The only thing I have to do now is tighten these back in. All right. Tighten that in so I don't fly out. First repair done. We did it, guys. Thank you so much. You guys helped me on that one. Look at that, you guys. A functioning seatbelt. Yes. All right. Let's test it out and see if it works. That would really stink if it didn't actually buckle. Hopefully. Woo! Thank you guys so much. All right, you guys helped me on that one. I did not know what to do. So thanks for telling me what to do. Next thing I'm gonna fix is on this car, and it is the shifter knob. So I actually like the knob in itself, but look at all those threads showing. I am not a fan of it. So I'm gonna put the original knob back on. Thank goodness he gave it to me when he sold it to me. So let's go ahead and do that. Oh, sweet. Ooh! Whoops. Okay. It's upside down. Almost there. Yes. Does that count as a repair? I think it does. Second repair, done. Guys, I'm so excited to be working on these. You have no idea. I've had the SN95 for a while and I've been meaning to work on these cars. So it's huge that I'm getting things done finally. So excited. It may not be much, but I'm getting started. The next thing I'm gonna do is on this car as well. I guess I'm kind of demodifying the car, but this thing. Now someone here told me in the comments that this actually adds 15 horsepower. I am not that dumb, you guys. I understand how some people like this and they might like it. That's fine. It's just not my style, so I am going to take it off. I'm gonna try to just pull it off because it's really hot today. Oh! Oh, yeah. Oh, this, it is so dirty. Oh, I cannot wait to wash this. Oh, I'm so glad this is coming off. I cannot wait to see it without this thing. That looks so much better. I love it. Okay, done. Third repair. Let's take a look at it without this thing. I don't know what it's called. Let's look at the car. Ugh, I like it so much better without that. What do you guys think? Do you like it better or did you like it with the added 15 horsepower? It does look good. It definitely, oh, I might have to get some remover for that, but that's okay. It's gone. That's all that matters. Hallelujah. As you can see, my day is not going very well today. I swear, every time I try to film a video, something happens. I cannot get this car to start. I don't know what's going on. I'm thinking it's the battery. I was just looking at the battery, and if you can see that sticker right there, it says 14. 2014, that's a pretty old battery, so I'm gonna go ahead and replace that. Hopefully I can get it started with this. I have it hooked up here to the truck, which you guys haven't seen in a while, but then hopefully it will at least start. We'll see. Since this battery is super old, I'm actually gonna go to get it checked to AutoZone. This is going super slow. I'm just gonna twist it off. Even though some of you might kill me for this, it's okay. I'll wash my hands after. Holy cow, these look old. There we go. Almost done. Then we can get going over there. Oh man, there's another bolt down there. Let it never be said that I can't take a battery out. This is like the fourth time I've done it. Oh, there's, I bet that's battery acid down there. Gross. All right, little battery. Let's go get you checked. Oh, got the battery out. Shut this so nobody steals my super expensive part. Wait, I don't know why I'm shutting it, because it's not going anywhere without a battery. All right, I'll just leave it open. Let's go. Let's go get ourselves a new battery. Mustang week. I'm so excited. I'm actually from Maryland. I grew up in Maryland and everybody went to Myrtle Beach for like spring break and summer, and I have never been. I cannot wait to go. If you're going, please let me know. I would love to meet some of you. I don't really know what to expect. So if any of you guys have ever been there, let me know. Let me know what there is. What's the best food to eat? Where to go? I'm assuming there are different events. Tell me which the best ones are. And remember, I'm only there until Friday, so hopefully I can go to all the awesome ones. Let's go inside. I'm kind of nervous because I never filmed inside AutoZone. Oh my gosh, you guys, look what I just found. It looks like a 67 pony. Holy cow, that is beautiful. I would totally buy it if it wasn't white. Just kidding, probably too expensive, but those are so cool. I love them. Right now we're gonna get it tested and we'll see how the battery actually is.
Just setting the 12 cranking amps to know how strong the battery is. So it says grid needs charged. It would just need to get a good charge. So we could charge it, it would take a couple hours, or you could charge it with a trickle charger overnight. And then you'd know after that if it was a good or a bad battery. So it's gonna be $73.99. That's counting this as the core, and then the discount for the price on the other.
Perfect. All right. This is really heavy. You guys, this battery was $158 and I just got it for $68. Yes. All right, now that that's done, let's go home and put it in. That's what she said. Just kidding. That was a bad one. I might edit that out. Oh, I love that Mustang. That's so cool. Oh, okay. I am so excited to be working on these cars, and thank you guys so much for all the comments, because you have helped me out so much. I honestly did not know where to start, and people have been like, do this, do this, do this. You've helped me with everything, so thank you so much. I love you guys. I feel like I'm the battery replacement channel, because I feel like that's all I do is battery stuff. I get these little doohickeys. I'm afraid. On here. Oh! Don't fall. It's like my worst nightmare, losing something in the engine. Or my engine catching on fire is another one. Tighten it. All right. All done. Now let's see if this bad boy starts. If it blows up, we know I did it wrong, and don't do it the way I just showed you. All right, cross my fingers. You guys, I am so thankful that started up, because I had no idea why it wasn't starting this morning. Hallelujah, it was just the battery. Someone on here was so nice and actually sent me some parts for my Fox body, and I'm really excited. This is my first package ever. Oh, have a nice day and enjoy your Fox. Just like opening birthday presents when like it's kind of awkward opening it on camera. Oh yes, I forgot to explain that one on camera. I'm missing one of these. Thank you so much. That saves me. Okay, I don't know, break anything. This. Oh, no way. You sent me the light thing. Oh, that's gonna look awesome up there. Oh, yes. New light, new light. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Love all the new subscribers here. Welcome to my channel, and we'll see you guys next time.